He is a pillar of Philippine business who built his empire spanning from banking, retail, to aviation. John Gokongwei Jr., fondly referred to as Mr. John. One of the Philippines' wealthiest, has been an inspiration to entrepreneurs and business leaders alike.
I admire John Gokongwei, who really steer across, you know, and really create opportunities for Filipino people.
John remembers you up to a point and never begrudges you anything. And that, to me, is the best example of how a noted businessman should act.
The Boss Legacy Special on Mr. John Gokongwei Jr. airs first this Friday, 1:30 p.m. and 8:30 p.m. with further replays throughout the weekend. Only here on ANC, the ABS-CBN News channel. A pillar of Philippine business who built his empire spanning from banking, retail, to aviation. John Gokongwei Jr., fondly referred to as Mr. John, one of the Philippines' wealthiest, has been an inspiration to entrepreneurs and business leaders alike. In our legacy special on Mr. John, we take a look at the rags-to-riches story that has made him one of the country's most admired patriarchs and philanthropists. Hello, I'm Kathy Yang. Join me in this special edition on The Boss, The Legacy of John Gokongwei Jr.
He is the third wealthiest man in the Philippines, with a net worth of $5.3 billion, according to the latest count of Forbes magazine. His business empire spans aviation, food manufacturing, and retail, just to name a few, all under his flagship holding company, JG Summit. But for many of the people close to John Gokongwei Jr., Mr. John or Big John is a great friend and a loving father. Antonio Go fondly recalls how he formed a lifelong friendship with Mr. John. He says it all started when they organized a birthday party for his late father. One thing Go will never forget about his friend is his frugality, especially when their families went on vacations overseas.
Subsequently, we travel together, we go out together, have dinner, and sometimes without the wife, because the wife is very restrictive when it comes to his diet, and sometimes he likes to splurge. Mm-hmm. So we go out and enjoy ourselves, and then drink beer. Of course, I stopped drinking beer now. I'm wiser and older. Yes. Also, he would not enjoy expensive food either. There was one time we had a snow crab, and I told him half the price, and he said, "Wow, it's expensive." From then on, I know that I shouldn't do my calculation. Only 50%, I should do better in my calculation.
And it's not just known to those close to him. Even Mr. John's colleagues can attest to his frugality. Among them, former Ambassador Roberto Romulo, who also sits as independent director for the Gokongwei Group's retail business.
Mr. John is known to be a true Cebuano, Kuripon. And let me assure you, he lived up to his name until his death. And I can give you many instances of that.
But kidding aside, Romulo also recalls how he admired Mr. John's inherent entrepreneurial spirit, even during testy times between his own father and the Gokongwei patriarch.
Probably the early 80s, if I'm not mistaken, when not everybody knew who Mr. John was. And there was a classic battle in the annual general meeting of San Miguel Corporation. And coincidentally, my father, General Romulo, happened to be on the board of San Miguel and a close ally of the Soriano family. And yet, despite all the bitterness during that time, I distinctly remember my father reminded me that John Gokongwei was really the new entrepreneur who he respected a great deal, although he didn't necessarily agree with his sentiments about San Miguel at that time.
Romulo even tried unsuccessfully to sell a computer system to Gokongwei While Gokongwei didn't buy, he was impressed and gave Romulo several job offers through the years. He says Gokongwei was especially impressive because of his business sense and foresight.
Years later, again, I got a phone call, and I was in the escalator of a mall in Singapore. It says, "Mr. Romulo, this is John Gokongwei. I want you to join the board of Singapore Land." So what I'm basically saying is, John remembers you up to a point and never begrudges you anything. And that to me is the best example of how an individual, a human being, and a noted businessman should act. But more than that, he's always referred to as an entrepreneur. On the humor side, which irked me quite a bit, he would often refer to, look at me and say, "Oh, you've gained weight." And that was very true. I was 215 pounds at one point. And every time I saw him, he says, "You need to lose weight," which in a sense was the pot calling the kettle black. So though that's my memory of Mr. John.
Francis Chua, Chairman Emeritus of the Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry, also attested to the strong leadership of Big John.
He has a very strong character, a person who does not believe in defeat, a person who could control any situation. He will not let things to go his own way. He will try to do it in such a way that at the end of the day, he is still the one who is calling the shot.
As an entrepreneur, he was admired by business leaders from various industries. In fact, in 2017, the ASEAN Business Advisory Council awarded John Gokongwei the ASEAN Legacy Award, together with 9 other ASEAN members, when Manila hosted the event. Successful in his own right, Philippine Presidential Advisor for Entrepreneurship Joey Concepcion considers Big John as one of his biggest inspirations.
The last encounter I had with John Gokongwei was in the awarding ceremonies in 2017 at the Solaire, and I had a chance to sit down with him and asked him how does he keep himself busy and all of that. And he told me that even at his he doesn't really technically believe in retirement, he keeps himself busy by reading, swimming, and all of that. And he basically ensured that his children would really be able to take over when the time comes. And I guess you can see him as a father, basically as a mentor. And he was sharing his experiences. One of his employees who worked for him, his name is Mr. Kanta, who rejoined us, was working closely with Mr. John Gokongwei during his tenure in URC, and he worked overseas in one of their factories, and told me that he respected John Gokongwei a lot, no, for very sound, practical advice. I admire a lot of entrepreneurs like John Gokongwei who really steer across, no, and really create opportunities for the Filipino people, and to be able to create a landscape that I guess in the end inspires younger guys to dream the impossible, no? And I would say that I drew a lot of inspiration from him.
Indeed, his entrepreneurial spirit is worth emulating, and even touched individuals like famed Filipino architect and urban planner Filino Jun Palafox.
One thing that I like, he's so mentally honest. He would ask the right questions, and he probably get half the answers already when he asked the right questions. And I speak to his executives also, and his style of management, I'm told, and I think I also felt that is really, I think describing it in Filipino, tutok kulit dikit. Tutok kulit dikit. That's his style of management. He's so hands-on, even when he's a chairman, but he's still, like I remember one time, once or twice, I was invited to talk with him and James Goh and Lance Gokongwei and Frederick Goh, on Saturday afternoon, just brainstorming on a project that they were going to venture in. And I see him also as, I'm both humbled and honored when Forbes Asia Magazine cited both of us, four of us from the Philippines, as in the 48 Heroes of Philanthropy in Asia. Although his philanthropic endeavors are so great and so on, and I was humbled that I was, in 2013, I joined him in those who were cited. And one thing with him also is he's able to, that's why Management Association of the Philippines gave him the Citation Award as Management Man of the Year because his exemplary qualities as a leader and a manager, managing his firm into exceptional growth.
Spanning from banking, retail to aviation. John Gokongwei Jr., fondly referred to as Mr. John, one of the Philippines' wealthiest, has been an inspiration to entrepreneurs and business leaders alike.
I admire John Gokongwei who really steer across, you know, and really create opportunities for the Filipino people.
John remembers you up to a point and never begrudges you anything. And that to me is the best example of how a noted businessman should act.
The Boss Legacy Special on Mr. John Gokongwei Jr. airs first this Friday, 1:30 p.m. and 8:30 p.m. with further replays throughout the weekend, only here on ANC, the ABS-CBN News channel. He is a pillar of Philippine business who built his empire spanning from banking, retail to aviation. John Gokongwei Jr., fondly referred to as Mr. John, one of the Philippines' wealthiest, has been an inspiration to entrepreneurs and business leaders alike.
I admire John Gokongwei who really steer across, you know, and really create opportunities for the Filipino people.
John remembers you up to a point and never begrudges you anything. And that to me is the best example of how a noted businessman should act.
The Boss Legacy Special on Mr. John Gokongwei Jr. airs first this Friday, 1:30 p.m. and 8:30 p.m. with further replays throughout the weekend, only here on ANC, the ABS-CBN News channel. He is a pillar of Philippine business who built his empire spanning from banking, retail to aviation. John Gokongwei Jr., fondly referred to as Mr. John, one of the Philippines' wealthiest, has been an inspiration to entrepreneurs and business leaders alike.
I admire John Gokongwei who really steer across, you know, and really create opportunities for the Filipino people.
John remembers you up to a point and never begrudges you anything. And that to me is the best example of how a noted businessman should act.
The Boss Legacy Special on Mr. John Gokongwei Jr. airs first this Friday, 1:30 p.m. and 8:30 p.m., with further replays throughout the weekend, only here on ANC, the ABS-CBN News channel. He is a pillar of Philippine business who built his empire spanning from banking, retail, to aviation. John Gokongwei Jr., fondly referred to as Mr. John. One of the Philippines' wealthiest, has been an inspiration to entrepreneurs and business leaders alike.
I admire John Gokongwei, who really steer across, you know, and really create opportunities for the Filipino people.
John remembers you up to a point and never begrudges you anything. And that, to me, was the best.
Big John had a big impact on the Philippine business community. But according to many, his biggest legacy is on education. This passion came from his experience of being a breadwinner at the early age of 13 after his father passed away. This deprived him of the privilege to concentrate on his studies and instead make ends meet by selling what he can. While he was able to graduate from high school in the University of San Carlos in Cebu, getting a college degree was more challenging. But this changed later on in his life after he finished a business degree in the De La Salle University.
There's a little side story to it because I think when they were reviewing his records, of course his childhood is years in school. Mm-hmm. Were actually during the wartime, so records were not really complete. They realized he did not have a college degree. He was already taking courses in the Masters of Business Administration. So Brother Andrew asked him to take some back subjects, and he actually did. He took some tests before he could actually graduate finally in 1977.
DLSU also named its College of Engineering after the Gokongwei Patriarch, with Big John emphasizing the importance of engineers in nation building. For the De La Salle community, more than his contributions, Mr. John also left an important lesson worth emulating by everyone.
I could name many things, but there is one that really struck me, and it's his frugality and simplicity throughout all of these. Unlike other donors that in a sense literally barge in because they can, they can afford to barge in. You'd barely hear a word from him. He's very simple. He comes in the words of his own children, with lousy dressing. He didn't care. And he knew that what is important in life is that you're able to earn your keep, and when you have an excess, you share it with others. I'd hope that is the legacy that we will remember him by, because there are very few people, the best, the brightest, may not be able to share that. He's one wonderful hero for us, especially at this time.
Ladies and gentlemen, a pleasant afternoon.
In 2017, the Management Association of the Philippines recognized Gokongwei as Management Man of the Year. The award came years after he had already retired and had passed on the reins of the business to his children. Santiago Dumblao, member of MAP and Secretary General of the Association of Credit Ratings Agencies in Asia, says Mr. John's focus on education was also quite apparent on how he raised his children. He shares the three important encounters he had with Big John.
The first episode really revealed how really he thought of education as very important. And that education is preparation, and education is also essential for business continuity. And he was very education oriented. So his inquisitiveness was not just for its sake, but for some good purpose, for his business to grow. The second episode was that on the management interview. So I thought he had such a strong sense of family. It was the paternal concern. It was not a desire, but just a love. I want this son of mine to do good. So it was a concern. And
the third one,
I'm looking for a word for this. Perhaps it's focus. Focus in the sense that he wanted, he knew what he wanted, and he knew what he could let go, but would not let go. So if you have that steady focus, whatever, when you go into new ventures or give up ventures, you know, he has gone into ventures and gave it up. But in the end, you will see how it was very much of a pattern, macro pattern in his thinking long term. He got into telecom, solid.
Gave it up, yeah.
He got into many things and gave up. So in my own old age, I can see how beautiful the pattern of his long-term thinking was.
Big John is also seen as a rare breed of businessman who was able to give importance to his family even as he built his business empire from the ground up.
John is a very, very real example as far as a businessman is concerned. He does not only concentrate in doing his business, he also spends a lot of time teaching his children. It is a trait that I would say that a businessman should emulate, because a lot of businessmen, we put all our time in a business. In some way, somehow, we might have forgotten that there are children to attend to. But he was so strict, and you could see how successful is his children. Whether it's Lance, whether it's Rubina, or what.
When Mr. John turned 80 years old in 2006, he donated 20 billion pesos, $393 million, or half his shares in JG Summit to the Family Foundation. The donation was considered the biggest philanthropic endowment in Philippine history. For his best friend, this shows Big John cares not just about his own family, but also the bigger community.
I like to remember him as very caring for the, not only for the siblings and the nephews and nieces, but also for the community as well. And not only for the Philippines, but also globally. Mm-hmm. If you can look at his products and his services, it's not only in Philippines, it's all over Southeast Asia, from Vietnam, Thailand, Singapore, Indonesia, Malaysia, all the way to New Zealand and Australia. So that's really something for the Filipino people to emulate. They don't just think of the Philippines alone. Filipino is just as good as anybody else in the world. And you can excel if you only focus.
John Gokongwei Jr. may always be remembered as a business mogul and a philanthropist, but for the people close to him, Mr. John will always be a father, a friend, and for his best friend, his soulmate.
Yes, we are more than brothers because I would probably, to the extent of even dying for him if necessary, you know. During his last few hours, really hurts me to see him suffer. Well, I'm sure he's in a better place.
When I was 13 years old, my father died, leaving me to take care of my mother, my brother, and my sister. At the time, my youngest brother, James, was only 9 months old. I took care of them all because the family has always been my priority. Used to wake up before dawn to ride my bicycle to the public market many kilometers away. I set up a little table in the market to sell spools of thread, bars of soap, and candles. I earned about 20 pesos a day by working longer and harder than everybody else. But it didn't matter since I really love my work. I love being an entrepreneur. Through the years, I stayed an entrepreneur, loving what I did, working hard, and always learning from the school of life. I always tell my children, my grandchildren, and my colleagues, love your work, work harder, love your family, love your country, never stop caring. And always look back and be grateful to where you came from. Thank you.
Spanning from banking, retail to aviation. John Gokongwei Jr., fondly referred to as Mr. John, one of the Philippines' wealthiest, has been an inspiration to entrepreneurs and business leaders alike.
I admire John Gokongwei who really steer across, you know, and really create opportunities for the Filipino people.
John remembers you up to a point and never begrudges you anything. And that to me is the best example of how a noted businessman should act.
The Boss Legacy Special on Mr. John Gokongwei Jr. airs first this Friday, 1:30 p.m. and 8:30 p.m. with further replays throughout the weekend, only here on ANC, the ABS-CBN News channel. He is a pillar of Philippine business who built his empire spanning from banking, retail to aviation. John Gokongwei Jr., fondly referred to as Mr. John, one of the Philippines' wealthiest, has been an inspiration to entrepreneurs and business leaders alike.
I admire John Gokongwei who really steer across, you know, and really create opportunities for the Filipino people.
John remembers you up to a point and never begrudges you anything. And that to me is the best example of how a noted businessman should act.
The Boss Legacy Special on Mr. John Gokongwei Jr. airs first this Friday, 1:30 p.m. and 8:30 p.m., with further replays throughout the weekend, only here on ANC, the ABS-CBN News channel. He is a pillar of Philippine business who built his empire spanning from banking, retail, to aviation. John Gokongwei Jr., fondly referred to as Mr. John. One of the Philippines' wealthiest, has been an inspiration to entrepreneurs and business leaders alike.
I admire John Gokongwei, who really steer across, you know, and really create opportunities for the Filipino people.
John remembers you up to a point and never begrudges you.